Niloufar. She won the Miss Teen Malaysia 2009 beauty competition. She's an actress, TV presenter, commercial model, and has her own business which got her into the Forbes 30 entrepreneur category. She's worked with Gucci, Vogue, Louis Vuitton, and loads more, representing modest hijabi fashion. She has 7.9 million followers on Instagram, which even got her an award, not mentioning her numerous other television awards. But all this changed this week when she decided to adorn the niqab. That's right, the face covering. Why? Why would someone with the beauty and fame that she has choose to do this? Assalamu alaikum guys, and welcome to another episode of Smile to Jannah. Yes, your eyes are not deceiving you. This is a blue hat. I thought I would go one shade lower. Feeling a bit wild, yeah? Just like our sister Niloufar, who is going against all the societal norms, going against what is defined within the fabric of freedom nowadays.
What?
And our sister, mashallah, may Allah bless her, has taken it upon herself to, mashallah, go to the A-star level of modesty. And you know what? If feminism was a thing,
was that meant to be a thing?
Apparently.
Okay.
Then they would be celebrating what the likes of our sister Niloufar and Zahra Wasim, Sana Khan have done. They're literally swimming against the tide. Yeah, they are going against the wind. They are the true rebels. They are the ones really standing up for themselves and for their gender. Because let's face it, mainstream media uses women in movies, in advertising, for their bodies. Yeah, even the roles that they have, it's there to compliment the hero. She's just there to look very nice and pretty. I mean, even in wrestling, the women's thing, it's not taken seriously. Even women's football. I mean, when is the next England women's match? Who knows, mate? And even in Indian movies, they call it an item song. That's right, the women are just there. It doesn't make sense to the storyline. And you know what's even more sick? Look at the uniform in secondary school. It is obligatory for little girls to wear skirts. That's all I'm saying.
I will choose to ignore that.
Sorry guys, forgot to add this bit in. I'm currently editing, so I thought, let me just sandwich this bit in, yeah? Some people, they say, what's the point in having youth and good looks if you can't parade them about? Well, if that's the logic that you're applying, why don't you apply that same logic to your money, yeah? Why don't you parade around with your money? I think you and I will both agree the reason is that you don't want to get violated and hurt because of that. Yeah, in fact, in the UK, this year, the conviction rate for being violated inappropriately is only 1%, the conviction rate, yeah? 99% of the cases are not being convicted, yeah? Of course, COVID and lack of policing is not helping the situation, but that is absolutely ludicrous. And constant use of sexualization is affecting males in a negative way as well. The mental health of males. Yeah, like this concept of simping and going on these OnlyFans sites and paying silly amounts of money just to speak to a female or just to see a picture. People are selling their pictures and people are, I mean, what can be said? You know, when we lose modesty, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if a person doesn't have shame, then he or she will do as they please. And that's exactly what we're seeing in our society. So as Muslims, we shouldn't be on the back foot. In fact, we have the solutions to the ills in our society.
Those of you still wondering why she took this decision, maybe she got sick and tired of being objectified. Maybe she's sick and tired of being eye candy for an industry that even the industry leaders themselves accept how women are being violated in it. Maybe she just wants to get close to her Lord, please her Lord, rather than pleasing perverts. Whatever the reason may be, she asked us on her Instagram page for our du'as and she acknowledged the fact that, mashallah, she is starting this journey and she is by no means perfect. I think that's a brilliant way to start, because some people are still under that impression that hijabis or niqabis think that, you know, we're better than everybody, even though some of them might think that. I don't know why on earth, because putting a cloth on your head doesn't make you perfect. It just shows to other people that you have started a path. And it was really nice to see her mother support her as well, and her showbiz friends also sending her messages of support. Of course, there may be many sisters watching that have embarked on a similar path as that of Niloufar. We also pray that Allah accepts from you. May Allah bless you. And those sisters that are yet to start that path, may Allah strengthen you. May Allah assist you in whatever obstacles lie in your path. It's very difficult nowadays for our sisters. Of course, even facilities wise, our brothers, mashallah, they have a lot of facilities and they're able to go and recharge their iman. For sisters, it's very difficult. So when you see sisters like this, I definitely think it should be celebrated. Yeah, this is the sign of true strength, that even in the sight of temptation, you are able to say, no, let me embark on this path. Because this sister knows, you know what, this sister knows that her sponsorships are going to go down. Yeah, even her getting picked on certain programs is going to go down. So for someone in her position to do this, I think my words are too cheap to articulate her true sacrifice. And I pray, and please guys, also pray for her and other sisters. And not just praying, in whatever capacity that you're in, if you organize lectures or do whatever in your local community, please, please, please don't forget the sisters. Yeah, don't forget the sisters. We love moaning and groaning.
Hot your mouth.
When the hijabs come off. But I mean, we don't look at the root causes. Yeah, we don't want to take blame on ourselves. We love dishing out the dirt. In many cases, I would say that as a community, we are to blame as well. Because ask yourself, I mean, what is there in your community? But let's take it upon ourselves. If you have some ideas, definitely drop them in the comments below.
Bang!
And yeah, let's leave it there, guys. Until next time. Assalamu alaikum.